take over from here.
Yeah. So am I audible, Arpan?
Yes, sir. Please go ahead.
Yeah. So good afternoon, everybody. Good afternoon, Edwin, Mr. Sharma, and every participant. Happy to be here. I think if I just go back as far as what our experience was when the post the lockdown, because the lockdown in India, which has happened, has been probably much more severe than what has happened in the rest of the world. Post the lockdown on 24th March, I think what we experienced has been disruptions in terms of whether we talk about the three L's basically, which labor, logistics, resulting into liquidity issues in the entire system. We saw supply disruption into the plants, even though while we would like to start our activities, we wanted to start up the plants. There were restrictions with respect to opening up. The opening up started very gradually with smaller amounts of laborers. The transporters could not get in, while the clarification kept on coming from the Ministry of Home Affairs. But I think there were restrictions by local administration. So you saw drivers, you know, not able to actually transport the material, getting stuck at the borders. You saw a lot of uncertainty and fear among various constituents of the societies about this pandemic, resulting in many people, let's say, moving out or leaving their jobs for some time, or the drivers moving out, leaving the truck where it is. So there was a lot of impact, I would say, which we saw in the first 1 month. Demand naturally had there was a sharp demand shock which came in, and therefore we saw a sharp contraction in the month of April. In the month of May, I think, as Mr. Sharma was also saying, we have seen a substantial improvement. Now, how the improvement, as we see from the industry perspective, like we in JSW, we could reach a level of capacity utilization of 83%. And that was primarily, again, driven by the fact that, yes, we saw that domestic would take some time, but we pushed exports and saw that the utilization of our production facilities is enhanced to make sure that the cost is maintained at an optimum level. So we were able to really get into the market in a very big way. We saw an improvement in the month of May vis-a-vis April in the domestic sector. Some projects for the government which picked up, some other construction sector specific, let's say in smaller cities, we saw there was a pickup where the number of laborers required are less. So we have a smaller construction where 8 to 10 laborers or 15 laborers are required. We saw traction in those. And so we saw those picking up, pre-monsoon activities picking up, packaging and solar picking up. So yes, there has been an improvement from a demand which had contracted very rapidly in April to, let's say, about 40% level in the month of May. As we go forward, I think we are seeing improvements in the month of June. There is an activity because everybody has started opening up, whether with 50% labor or with more. Demand to some extent has come back. So now we see that while the journey is going to be taking some time as far as India is concerned, but we are seeing improvements going along on a monthly basis. And I would say that maybe this time we would see July, September to be probably in terms of utilization also a little better than a normal monsoon season, because there is some pent-up demand. People are coming back. You see people are getting back to work. Personal mobility is an issue. People would like to buy smaller cars, two-wheelers. So you will see some impact of this demand coming in the July-September quarter as well. And I think we should be able to move the curve upwards from a demand perspective in India and maybe reach about 80% level in October, December, and maybe pre-COVID levels by Jan, March. Having said that, I think while the export opportunity is one which India is seeing as a big one today, Southeast Asia has been, ASEAN specifically, has been a big market for India. Probably close to one third of our business has been coming from the ASEAN side. India exports about roughly 30% to the ASEAN region. China has come in, I think, during this period of time, we see to complete ASEAN, there is a supply gap which has emanated because there were some shutdowns in Japan and Korea also, which are actually major supplies to the ASEAN region. And those supply gaps is an opportunity for the country to meet. We see China coming into an import market in a much larger way. They have actually added to the requirement in the Asian market. And so therefore, this opportunity has been, utilized by most of the Indian steel players, and therefore export has found a very big support. So during this period of H1, where the domestic picks up gradually, I think export will continue to give the buffer to utilize and do the volumes till the domestic comes back to a reasonable level in H2. If you look at the opportunity which I see in India, I think there are supply chain disruptions which are happening in the world. Many industries, many companies are thinking of relocating their supply chains from countries, specifically China, and that's a big opportunity for India. So I think the government is sensitized on this issue, and appropriate steps are being taken to attract investment into India. So I see a focus on basically three things which is going to emanate now. More and more of deglobalization, which is going to happen as far as the domestic demand is concerned. So you will see a focus on Make in India and Buy in India. And you will see local to global as a way of going forward to create or rather take this opportunity of supply disruptions, have the basis in India and global from India. So engineering exports are going to increase. So I think this opportunity is large, and the way we see the possibility of replacing engineering imports into India is big. $110 billion of imports of various goods on the engineering side is right now happening. And there's a potential to replace that, become also an additional exporter into the world market. And that's a huge opportunity. We see the infrastructure pipeline, which the government had already laid out. And I think initiatives have been taken to prepone and front load that pipeline. So we see infrastructure activities picking up, and that would give the kind of an impetus for job creation and the demand, because 60% of steel, after all, is consumed in construction and infra. The agri sector and I would say dairy, fisheries, this is one more area where we are seeing traction. And I think with a lot of effort, which is now going to go into creating avenues of infrastructure, cold storage, in the rural side, we will see a lot of activities building up on that front as well. So that would pick up. And we see packaging industry now, I think, because post pandemic health hygiene has become very important. We see an impetus on the packaging side. Things have picked up on the packaging side as well. And we see India now, I think, we are a reasonable sized exporter, and we see India responding to the export market in a much better way. But we need some relaxations or refunds of non-creditable taxes, which we pay in India, which get exported out. I think the government is looking into that, and probably it would come sooner than later, and that would encourage exports in a big way. So we have, if you look at the opportunities, replace imports of steel, replace the indirect imports which are happening through the engineering imports, become an export base both for steel and for engineering exports from India, in addition to what opportunities we are likely to see in the domestic market, which is infrastructure pipeline, the rural side build up, which we talked about. So I think, yes, the pandemic has impacted all of us. There is a new normal, as people talk about. Health and hygiene will become important. Social distancing is important, but yes, life will go on. And I think the H2 will be far better. And as Edwin said, while the numbers can be debated with respect to the fall of demand in this year, but the primary loss which is coming in this this year is emanating out of the lockdown period of April and May. So post that, I think activities would pick up. So we are also optimistic that gradually things in India would improve. Thank you, and I would hand the mic back to Apan.
Sure. Thank you, sir.